Hello, hello, welcome on my channel. Today a video about connecting two VPC networks together using peering connection. And in the next video, in the second part, I show you that you can also create a peering connection between transit gateways. To easily demonstrate how peering works, I created two networks in the same region. However, networks can be in different regions and even in different AWS accounts. Let's start with theory, then I will show you what creating a peering connection looks like in practice. If you have VPC A, B and C and you have already created a peering connection between VPC A and VPC B and VPC B and VPC C, then you can connect from A to B and from B to C, but you will not connect from VPC A to VPC C. If you need to communicate from A to C, you also need to create a peering connection from VPC A to VPC C. If you need to connect two networks that have the same AP range, I encourage you to watch my other video, in which I talk more about this topic. Now, a short intro and then I will go to the AWS console. As you can see, I don't have any VPC subnet or routing table in this region. I'm starting from scratch. First, I will create one VPC with one availability zone. One public and one private subnet. I will do the same for the second VPC. One availability zone, one public and one private subnet. Now EC2. I will create one EC2 machine in each public subnet. If you want to connect to the machine like I do, you must also allow the appropriate traffic in the security group. But you probably already know that. For now, as you can see, I have two VPC networks. There is one EC2 machine in each public subnet. Now, there is currently no connection between these two EC2 machines. I will copy the IP of the second EC2. Connect. As you can see, there is no connection. Now I want to show you a great tool that can make your work easier. If you want to check the connection between two points in the AWS cloud, you can use Reachability Analyzer. Great tool. I have also used this tool many times and I can recommend it. Add some name. Select the first EC2 machine, the source, the one you want to connect from, and then choose the second EC2 machine here, the one you want to connect with. Of course, the tool offers much more than just checking the connection between two EC2 machines. If you don't know this tool yet, I definitely recommend spending some time on it and learning how to use it, because it's great and easy to use. As you can see, there is no connection. So, let's go back to creating a peering connection. Go to VPC, peering connection, create peering connection. Add some name. Here you can choose source, VPC A. As you can see, you can select a different region or different AWS account. But I choose from my account and from this region. And destination, VPC B. Create peering. Now you need to accept this connection in destination region and account. I can do this from this action menu. Action, accept request. Accept request. Okay, ready. Now you need to add route to route table. First route table. I want to add route from VPC A to VPC B using peering connection. And in second route table, I want to add a route from VPC B to VPC A using peering connection. Save changes. Now let's go to EC2. Instances. Connect. Let's connect to first EC2 machine. Connect. As you can see, now you can connect from server A in VPC A to server B in VPC B. Connected to server B. Now let's check server B. Connect. As you can see, here also you can connect from server B in VPC B to server A in VPC A. Connected from private IP server A to private IP server B. Okay, let's check also Reachability Analyzer. As you can see, on the beginning we can connect. Let's check again now. Action. Analyze path. Confirm. Wait a moment. Pending. Refresh. Yes. Reachable. As you can see, now you can connect from server A to server B. And you can view all resource path. From server A to server B. Server A, network interface, security group, access control list, route table. This is our peering connection. Can access control list, security group, network interface, and our destination, server B. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to give it the like and subscribe the channel if you haven't yet. Don't miss the next part where I will talk more about peering between transit gateways. Oh, of course, check my blog on lepczynski.it. You will find there a lot of tutorials that will show you how to use the AWS cloud and take you step by step to the next level. Thanks for watching.